Okay,
we're live. Wala pa pang may gusto sumali.
Nando wala naman na. Yung link eh.
Okay.
Ayan, so, welcome. All right. Ayan, okay. Good evening. Welcome to our test broadcast, the stream with StreamYard, Agonoy with Keepsakes together with our colleagues from DTV Pilipinas, or how should I describe it?
Oh.
So, sige, on my right muna, let's get to Red Mendoza from UC.
Hi, I am Red Mendoza. And sorry kung medyo narinig ko yung sarili ko, pero I'm using a complicated setup right now. And welcome to this test stream for all of you followers and likers of Keepsakes. And I hope you're going to enjoy our randomness here today. We're just testing everything here, okay? So sit back and enjoy the show.
Testing, testing. Okay na.
Okay na. Delay.
Nagde-delay ba sa akin?
Dinig ka.
Alright.
Pat na naman ako. My God. It's hard on mobile data. Wait lang. Ayan.
Kaya lang eh. Eh, inaasikaso ko eh. No?
Ayan. So, I should be back again.
Nagpa-park na nga. Nag-ano na ako.
Ayan. Dapat nagbalik na ako. Ayan ang time out. Ayan. So, let's get to my bottom si Kyle. Kyle Flo.
Yeah, good evening. This is Kyle Flo.
Kyle Flo po, Lapso Oshimo.
Ayun na?
Lapso Oshimo.
Alam niyo na yun. Wala.
Ayan, and then on sa ating on the right, the bottom right, we have Dennis Martinez. Good evening.
Yes, good evening from La Union.
Kumusta ang La Union, bossing?
Under ECQ. Pero thank God, COVID-free pa rin naman ang taon namin.
Ayun. Doon sa, I think yung mga COVID cases na sa bandang La Union is parang, wala na ako nababalitan ng mga katropa ko sa Solid North eh. Mga katropa ko sa Solid North cosplay community dyan sa ano, nakikibalita rin ako dyan eh. And so far, walang masamang balita so far. Ayan. So, okay. So, ang objective talaga ng discussion natin tonight is to test StreamYard. But then again, we can add more topics. We're here to talk about anything that has happened in the past.
Nung COVID. So, ito, naka...
Yes, go.
Naka... ano ko lang muna.
Yes, please.
Screen.
Ayan. So,
ayan.
Mm-mm. Okay na, naka-share screen na. So yes, Fred, take
Ayun.
It away.
Okay. Ayan.
This is the latest case count ng COVID. 6,087 confirmed, 397 deaths, and 516 recovered. So very good na ngayon na we have 516 people recovering from the coronavirus. And of course, this is the data from my employer. Okay, so yun na yun.
Alright.
So, asa na tayo? Pero compared to the number of cases yesterday, ano na ba ngayon? Is it going up? Is it plus or minus pa?
Yeah. Well,
steady.
Yes, we have been expecting 200. We have been tracking 200. We have been tracking 200 na mga kaso every day. So that's a good average already. Hindi na yung tulad, I think that was last week, when we got into 500, yung nag-peak tayo ng 500. So right now, all's good, pero of course, the case count is still rising, and of course, the good thing here is the number of recoveries is now rising. We have now more recoveries than the number of deaths. Pero of course, hanggang ngayon, sinasabi pa rin natin, sinasabi pa rin ng mga health experts, continue to stay at home. Stay at home.
So yun, in that sense, pag sinabing stay at home, we're talking about the quarantine period. Are there any info so far from the interagency task force about the plans? Are there any plans to extend the quarantine period further?
Okay. Right now, of course, ang mga nababalitan natin from our palace reporter, and of course, tunay sa mga public pronouncements from the IATF is that the ECQ is still on target on April 30. Of course, excuse me. We do expect na may malalimang pag-aaral doon sa magiging sinasabi nga nila doon yung normal or yung mangyayaring slow integration or the slow the IATF is thinking about possible na mga scenarios lifting the quarantine, lifting the lockdown, or making it partial lockdown, select cities, municipalities, barangays, sitio, everything is under the table, everything is on the cards right now, and of course, once na nagkaroon ng final decision ng IATF, then of course, they will inform us and we will report it, of course.
So yun ano, sa kabila ng lahat ng mga info na nilabas na ng IATF through its virtual press cons, which are basically happening every day except Sunday. Sunday ba merong presser?
Wala.
So Monday to Saturday lang, tama?
Mm-hmm.
Ayun, kasi Linggo is araw ng pahinga. So moving further, kasi nakabalita tayo ng mga, there are floating speculations na baka ma-extend uli ang quarantine, in which wala pang na-announce ang IATF, hindi pa na-announce sa Twitter, so hindi pa natin alam. Pero nagpapauna na dito yung mga kasama ko sa work. So, we'll see. I'll wait and see. And most importantly, yes, I'll tap to red to get, kasi you're the desk man, at your employer there. Ayan, so, yan. So, labas lang natin to. No? Good evening, si Gary Montejo ng Cebu. And good evening, ayan. So, yan yung correspondent natin, yan, one of our partners in Cebu. Good evening, Gary. So, yan, no? Again, we are with the guys from DTV Pilipinas. Kyle, kumusta dyan sa area mo?
Okay lang, makakalabas naman.
Nakalabas naman. So, ikaw yung may hawak ng quarantine pass?
Wala kaming quarantine pass. Hindi kami kailangan. Baka hindi na namin, baka hindi sa amin kinikailangan ng quarantine pass. Hindi nag-distribute ang barangay namin.
Ah, yun lang. Yun na masaklap.
Hindi, okay lang naman yun kasi nga, free to roam naman kami. Pero sa amin naman, kahit naman sa amin sa barangay, meron kaming, let's say, dahil restrain namin sa sarili namin dito, we know our bounds. So siguro, kaya hindi na kami kinilangan ng quarantine pass.
Ah, okay.
More so, of self-discipline kasi nangyayari sa amin.
Interesting. Kasi, di ba initially, within the first few weeks ng quarantine, ang system is yung quarantine pass, not necessarily needed. Pero nowadays, as the weeks go on, kailangan na rin yung quarantine pass.
Di pa kasi kami binabalaan ng barangay namin.
Mm-hmm. So basically, wala pang kaso sa inyo technically?
Actually, meron. Pangalawa kami sa Marikina, I believe. Walong kaso namin.
Okay.
One fatality.
Wow, 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 wow. Pero, di ba, malapit kayo sa supermarket?
Tama? Oo, dalawang supermarkets.
Dalawang supermarkets.
Tapos yung Alphamart, yung 7-Eleven. Kaya walang problema.
Ayos, ayos. So, yun, no? Kanina nakamusta na natin si Boss Dennis about sa situation sa La Union. Okay, so we've talked about the COVID-related cases. Dito naman sa Pasig, all things are going smooth. And wala tayong masyadong ano, no? Ang balita kay Mayor Vico, nag-update naman siya about dun sa... The last case I've heard is yung sa social amelioration program ng DSWD, if I'm not mistaken. Ano. Tapos, of course, in the national scale, sa small enterprises, there is a plan to subsidize or to give support sa mga small businesses provided that the employers themselves will register their companies sa social security system through the MySSS portal. So, that's the news so far. Gusto kong sumali ni Gary. Sige, bibigay natin yung link later. Pero for now, sige, ano, gusto nyo, ano, kasi this is from Cebu. You want to get updates from Cebu? Yes.
Ayan. Sige. Sige, ano muna, before we go muna dun sa COVID updates muna, and of course, actually, this was a plan talaga to do DTV PH live using streaming techniques yung ginagamit nga sa mga broadcasters, no, to do work from home. We wanted to try Zoom, pero we Zoom. Heard those issues.
You can say the magic spells and then you get suspended. magic spells ba?
Yeah, yung issues.
The security issues.
Zoom. Security issues. Kaya we wanted to do using WebEx. Pero
WebEx talaga.
My computer is having problems. So kaya nung nalaman namin na one network, itago na lang natin sa pangalang TV5, is using StreamYard. Mm-hmm. So, try namin. And look at where we are now.
Mm-hmm. This is so, it. So, yun. Again, for the record, ang mga clients ni StreamYard is Gary Vaynerchuk, serial entrepreneur, motivational speaker. I can't call him a motivational speaker. He doesn't want to be called such. Yeah, the Five Network, One News, and si Pocholo Gonzales, include na rin natin dyan. Mm-hmm. So again, we're testing StreamYard, and then eventually we're going full broadcast na. This was supposed to be DTV PH Live, pero for the meantime, since may concerns nga sa unit ni Red, we're live on Keepsakes. All of a sudden. Mm-hmm. So, ayan.
Yun naman na, we're trying to do WebEx na lang. We'll try yun ang WebEx pa rin.
Ay, WebEx. WebEx.
Pero WebEx, I'm trying this, ano WebEx, eh. Pwede ko gawin itong streaming laptop. Kasi company laptop ito eh.
Mm-mm.
So I'll try to make this as just the host computer. Tapos gamitin itong akin, itong ginagamit ko right now. Bale, ito yung pang-OBS ko.
Mm-mm.
Mm-hmm. Kaya kasi so far, gagawa ako ng isang dummy account just for the host account.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so okay yung WebEx eh. Kilala ko yung WebEx na yun. Parating nababanggit yun sa bawat circular. Sa ano. Pero WebEx sa akin is not quite okay. I don't know why.
Network siguro, no?
Oh, network siguro. Pero again, just to put this on the record, I'm using mobile data. Streamer is recommending wired connections. Ayun. So, yeah. That's it for now dito sa area natin sa DTV. StreamYard can fit up to 6 people on screen. So, I was asking earlier, should we include a situation report from Cebu?
sige, sama lang natin. Baka, kasi yung mga, I think, other, okay. our guests hindi pa rin makasama. May ibang, I don't know.
Sige, standby natin ang ating Cebu partner, okay. si Gary.
Check, test.
Narinig niyo ako. Again, yes, yes.
Okay, pasensya na. Kasi yung Manicam kasi, I always listen to echo. Kasi nag-i-echo yung boses ko. Kaya,
Kaya ano ba kayo sinagay? Wireless?
No.
Wireless pa ang bagamit?
Lapit.
Try mo maganda. I mean, what I mean is, yung ano mo, yung from routing mo from cellphone to laptop.
Manicam?
Kasi, yun ang iniiwasan ko kasi I don't use Manicam. Ang ginagamit ko yung, yung Epoch. Kaso nga, kasi, I'm using the free version kasi yun nga, may bayad. May bayad yung
So, yun. Pasensya na kung medyo nabago yung audio nung microphone ko. Pero yun nga, kasi iniiwasan ko lang talaga yung feedback. Yung feedback on my
end. Ayan, so may, of course, Ayan. So waiting lang tayo from to our to our colleagues Cebu how to reply okay. this.
Una muna bago muna natin pasukin si
Yes, Sir go, Gary. Go muna
of course. Coronavirus changed everything, of course. That's why we are here right now. We are at home right now. Everything changed. I mean, the last time we talked on DTV Pilipinas Live, we were just discussing about ABS-CBN's franchise.
Yes. Medyo rin, napahaba tayo din eh.
We were just discussing about ABS-CBN franchise, but now, everything flipped in a second. Na everything happened because of coronavirus and everything came to a halt. Everything stopped. So, what happened? Of course, everything had ang dami na bago. Production stop. Audiences were not allowed. we all know audiences were not allowed. Nagsimula sa Ikbulaga and then Showtime and then, yun na, diretso na, telesera, production stop. And it all went down from there until being started the quarantine period last March. March 16. March 16, March 17. And yun nga, it's like the whole quarantine period is like parang Holy Week sa mga broadcasters. It's like the Holy Week or yung special programming yung ginagawa every Lenten season. Albeit, it's nakakapanibago kasi of course you'd expect na the network, of course dahil nga walang teleserye production, you expect the networks will be getting to their library of content. Yun nga yung mga kinuha pa nila mga teleserye titles is yung mga inspirational ones daw kasi nga they want to make people inspired from...
Kumbaga, messages of hope.
Yeah, yun, hope. They want people to be hopeful. Yun nga. So, ayun, it was different. Nakakapanibago na we're just discussing what ABS-CBN franchise. In the few weeks ago, we were last live. Now, this. I'm quite perplexed right now. Pero what I'm actually saying is na I'm lucky to be right now working at a newspaper right now covering this. Sinwerte lang talaga ako na nakapasok ngayon sa dyaryo because of this.
Siguro for the first time since tagal na natin, prior to DTV Pilipinas, we had ANB Pilipinas and magkakakalala na tayo ni JM, ni Kyle. So far, ito yung point talaga in life na lahat tayo may trabaho and we're thankful for that.
Yeah, I'm actually surprised na
the opening of Manila Times came as a big surprise to me. I only saw that on Facebook. And yun nga, I applied. And I got lucky na paso ako just before everything went to a standstill, at least for some of our friends in the workforce. And me, when the first week of the enhanced community quarantine, I stayed at the office. Nakapalibago, to say the least. Lumabas ako nung Saturday. I think bumili ako ng food. I will share something. I have a picture here. I have a picture here. Sandali lang.
Sige.
Pakita ko lang sa inyo yung espresso. Ipasok muna natin yung ating kasamang si Gary.
Gary, okay. So Gary from Cebu. Gary, good evening.
Hi. May gabi. Good. Yeah. Good evening, everyone.
Oo. Gary, you're actually with the people of DTV Pilipinas, as we mentioned earlier. No? So this is about digital television. Do you still do you have a TV at home?
No, I don't have a TV at home.
So, ano situation natin sa Cebu?
Well, Cebu, all I can say is ang daming nangyari sa Cebu, my God.
Sige, enumerate mo. Okay lang yan.
Well, I'm currently just copy-paste some information from a newspaper, and so far, nagkala natin yung pangalan Sunstar.
Sunstar, the community newspaper.
Yeah, yes, so it's total of 187 in Visayas. That's confirmed cases for coronavirus. Actually, a week ago, ano yan, wala talagang, hindi yan tumakbo, actually. We were 3 days na walang update or walang nagkaroon ng cases na lumabas until we just discover this Friday Barangay Luz and Labangon actually is in lockdown.
Barangay Luz.
They were able to identify that there were 77 cases.
77 cases.
Yeah.
Parang nabasa ko yung balita. I just forgot where I read it na technically everyone in Barangay Luz is infected.
That's what I heard as well. That's why I'm trying to check what's the latest update din kasi with Sunstar. But as far as my sources is concerned, 77 ang infected. So what the government has declared, lockdown na lang lahat.
We will lockdown na lang lahat. Ayun.
Well, everyone is infected and they should be doing something about it.
Kind of, for the record, how far are you from Barangay Luz?
Well, luckily, we're actually at the provincial area of Cebu. We're at the Manila is the southern part of Cebu. Then Barangay Luz is at the central or near Cebu City. Yeah. Well, I also got the news though that we are gonna have our number coding scheme scheduled starting on Monday.
Ngayon lang, first time na ipapatupad ang number coding.
Yeah,
to control the digital traffic.
Yeah, Cebu from City Monday, Wednesday, Friday, it's gonna be plate number ending with 13579. Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, 24680. Then on Sunday, no vehicles allowed. So parang nangyari dito
is that... No vehicles allowed on Sunday.
Yeah. So I think nangyari dito is that regardless na meron ganun na ano, na activities sa Cebu City, I think we're trying to slowly coming back to business. Except for the provincial area, we are still currently on our own lockdown as well. So Cebu City has been declared na lahat ng ano, wala talagang pwedeng pumasok. Bawal ang pumasok, bawal ang lumabas. Yun. Wow. Yung Cebu City area lang ah. Pero sa amin, sa Talisay, sa Talisay, which is also one of the provincial area in the southern part of Cebu, and which is also near Manila. There also they discovered a case, at least one or two cases. So they're also on lockdown, and medyo mahigpit talaga yung ano, mahigpit talaga yung checkpoint. Kasi prior to this, like at least mga 3 weeks ago, hindi talaga ang company namin, kasi hindi kami nag-work from home. The companies decided to go in-house. So in-house meaning to say we will be staying in a certain hotel, and then once mag-start yung shift namin, may magsusundo namin sa bus, and then from the bus pupunta sa office. After we're done with our shift, balik sa hotel. Yun yung routine namin for the last 2 weeks or 3 weeks ago. Pero ngayon, since kailangan na mag-budget si company, nag-transition na rin sila na we're gonna start working from home, and it's really kind of
stressful. Actually, you're using your equipment, sorry.
Yeah,
you're
using your equipment. Well, actually, I'm using the company's workstation or computers. So, imagine, dala ko yung dalawang monitor, isang CPU, at saka lahat ng paraphernalia or accessory, dala ko yan. Plus, lahat ng mga gamit ko, all the way from the hotel, papapauwi dito. And it was really stressful talaga. No, and the fact that dadaan pa sa Cebu City to Talisay, and when we went to Talisay checkpoint, it was really hard. Kasi talaga ang daming questions. Saan ka pupunta? Then, why are you, but ngayon ka lang uuwi? Ganun. Those questions that it's really, okay, you can just simply answer it with full confidence. Actually, pinakita ko lang yung authorization at saka yung certificate of employment, but it's kind of difficult as well, especially na, baka pagdudahan ka na you might be a carrier of the virus. So, we don't want
to... discrimination.
Not really discrimination.
Discrimination is real.
Yeah, it's not really discrimination, but parang naniniguro lang talaga sila. Better safe than sorry. So, right now, I'm done with my day, night 5 for my work from home. It was really difficult. Parang nag-a-adjust talaga yung katawan ko. Kasi once I get home, I really go to sleep. Pero ngayon, you wake up, you go to work by sitting down on your chair. And then after that, you go to sleep again. So, it's really weird, but I'm getting used to it.
All right. Sige. I appreciate na you're safe, you're great. And then you're adjusting to the new normal. I'm adjusting to the new normal as well. Kahit na ilang metro na ako sa opisina mula dito sa aking home base. So we will get back to Red from QC. So sige, Red, you're sharing something.
Ito. So ito yung week one nung quarantine. And this is just outside. Just near the office. Yung nakita ninyong white building na yan, it's the treasury building. Then, yung nakita ninyong big old building there, it's the Palacio del Gobernador, which is the headquarters of COMELEC. And you're seeing right now, yung daan na yan, Soriano Avenue. Andres Soriano Avenue. And you can see, that's near the Manila Cathedral, by the way. And just see, that's the week one of quarantine. Napakatahimik. Just look at that. Normally, I took that on a Friday. I think it was a Tuesday. Kinunan ko yan. Normally, ang daming tao dyan. Maraming tao, maraming sakyan. Bustling yan. But you just look there, it's quiet. Really quiet. Napakatahimik. So, you just see how this virus has just changed all of our thinking, changed all of our movements here, not just in Manila, not just in Cebu, not just in the Philippines, but across the globe.
I agree.
Just imagine na right now, it's already nearing 10 p.m., dapat lima gumiginig pa. May tao sa PPC. May tao sa Makati. May tao sa, God knows what.
Pero you're seeing this picture right now. Nakakagulat. You just can't imagine.
I think it's the same with any other places here. On my end is tahimik din, and in some days mahangin, and literal na mahangin. I tell you, as in mahangin dito. Kaya well, ano, kaya yung isang kwarto dito well ventilated yan, hindi na kailangan ng aircon.
Akala ko electric fan din maano eh.
Ah, hindi, electric fan talaga yung ano sa akin.
Okay.
Electric fan talaga yung ano sa akin ngayon kasi dito ako sa lab, sa living area. As in, literally living area. This is our living space. Literally, dito tayo nabubuhay ngayon as we stay at home.
Well, summer is here and, you know, talagang init.
Oh, mainit talaga. Oo. Mainit. So, gaano kainit dyan sa Cebu?
Yung parang alas 9 pa lang. Ay, hindi. Alas 8 pa lang umaga. Super init na.
Ah, oo. Ramdam ko yan, ramdam ko yan. 7 a.m. sinisilaban ako ng araw dito sa Kwan, sa bintana. 7 a.m. sinisilaban ako ng araw dyan. Yan. Is it the same situation with you, Kyle?
Okay naman eh. Ano, normally, umaga lang ako lumalabas eh. Kasi pag mga 12, ako, kaya ako mag-init. Talagang ano, it's really a way for us to stay home.
That's true. Mm-hmm.
It's a nature's way of saying stay home na lang. Kung ayaw mo magka-skin cancer, kung ayaw mo nga, sige, hindi ka nga nagka-COVID, pero nagka-skin cancer ka naman.
Na actually, dito sa area namin, dito sa Quezon City, kanina, ang lakas ng ulan.
Lakas ng ulan.
So, I don't know, kasi we had a long dry season. I mean, June, hindi masyadong ulan. Hindi pa masyado umulan ng June. Noong July, konti lang yung ulan. Right now, with the rains right now, as early as April, I'm guessing, we could have a long rainy season. And that's good news for us dito sa Metro Manila dahil kailangan ng tubig na Angat Dam.
Oh dear.
Kailangan. Much better kung yung tubig ulan ay talagang pupunta sa Angat.
Yun nga.
That's the thing that happens. Mm-hmm. I guess in Cebu, things are different. Gary, may dam ba kayo dyan sa Cebu?
Well, for water supply, we're totally fine actually. I think init din kasi. Then, actually, nung mga around 7 in the morning, parang narinig ko yung buhos ng ulan. I was about to, you know, pero ano eh, biglang tumigil eh. Nakakabitin nga eh. Kailangan talaga namin ng ulan kasi sobrang init. Misa nga, malakas na nga yung level ng electric fan namin. Talagang pinapawisan pa rin kami. Ganun kainit ang ano ngayon. Pero in fairness, I heard that, you know, the virus gets be killed because of warm temperature or hot weather. So, let's just say it's a blessing in disguise din na even though na, yes, it's better if we stay indoors and yes, it helps kill the virus. Pero I'm just hoping na, you know, sana everybody will just continue following the rules para sa ganun, hindi na tayo mag-extend sa lockdown. Kasi once it arrives to the cold season in the Philippines, talaga mahirapan tayo niyan. Just like the other countries in Italy and also in United States, I heard that the weather is really cold. So, viruses tends to, you know, continue living or mataas yung ano lifespan nila. So, that's what I'm really afraid of. I hope that everybody would just continue following what is needed to be followed. Para sa ganun, we can also, you know, stop this. And then we can continue with our normal lives.
Wala na, Gary. This is the new normal. Social distancing is the new normal. So Red, can you say something about dun sa weather and COVID-19?
Well, we have reports. We have already published reports, of course, saying of course there's some news website saying the heat of the sun down may or not may might help now delay in the spread of coronavirus, but of course hindi pa ito proven.
I see.
Hindi pa siya proven, so we are not sure yet. We are not out of the woods regarding the weather. The only thing na kailangan talaga natin is number one, physical distancing. I know people have been talking about social distancing. No, the World Health Organization says it's physical distancing. Why I know? Because I wrote that story for the Manila Times. It's physical distancing. It's the more legitimate term, kasi nga, we should be physically distanced from one another, but we should not end our social connections, interactions, like what we are doing right now. This is
social interaction.
So considering na this weekend was supposed to be cosplay carnival,
segue tayo dyan. Again, this is not Philippines, it's keepsakes, so anything goes.
Cosplay carnival. So with everything that's running, again, pinaliwanag din sa akin ito ni Bossing na this is the new normal. Mm-hmm. And we will no longer have the normal that we have, yung beso-beso, hindi niya normal. Yung
mga artista, hindi lang beso-beso yan.
Baka pwede nga eh. Baka pwede instead of shake hands and beso-beso, ang Wakanda na lang daw na sign.
Wakanda na lang? Or the other option, the Taiwan Taiwan greeting.
Ganon? Paano yun? Ah, ganon?
Ganito.
Ah, ganon? Okay.
Hi. Hello. Well, wish I saw some isang video ni Taiwan President Tsai Ing-wen on Twitter. She's active on Twitter. 1 million followers. So, yun, no? you'll hear more of Taiwan from me. Taiwan is like Japan number two in terms of entertainment and the culture. The anime culture in Taiwan is at par with Japan's, if I estimate it. So, you know, okay. All right. Do we have any further questions from our group here? May gusto pang idagdag, Red. Dennis. Sorry, ah. Sige ko lang. Your place is among the hottest places in the country. It's an understatement to ask you, gaano kainit diyan?
Mainit, nakakapaso pag lalabas ka ng bahay. Pero ano naman, kanina umulan. Luckily umulan. Medyo malamig ngayong gabi. Masarap patulog mamaya. Ayos.
I went to La Union once and pagka-uwi ko from Manila, nagka-sore ako. And then that was long time ago, no? My bad. Pero moving to the heat, nagka-sunburn naman ako while I was trying to do my grocery shopping on one Saturday during this quarantine period. The first 2 weeks. So, sino ngayon yung may quarantine pass? Ayan, that's a big question. Sino sa inyo may quarantine pass? Gary, you have quarantine pass.
So, I don't have a quarantine pass, pero I'll show you something. Sandali lang. Sandali ko lang muna yung camera ko. Pass mo
eh. Ayan, i-share mo muna,
Sa akin, when I went back to here in Magnanilia, I immediately had to go to the barangay and request for a quarantine pass. And they asked me, why am I asking right now? Sabi ko, kababalik ko lang, all the way from Cebu City, for onboard. And then I also requested for a, ano, if they have a certain donation or food that is intended for each household. So since I am representing the household, one of my household, so eh nga, binigyan naman din ako. And binigyan din ako ng quarantine pass. Our barangay is very generous. Kahit na may sakong, may, hindi siya sakong bigas, isang bag na bigas, tapos meron siyang dilata at saka noodles. That's actually enough. And it actually lasted for, hindi siya naubos actually. Kasi ako lang naman talaga mag-isa dito sa bahay. Pero it was like 5 days. After the next 5 days, may pumunta sa amin. Then nagpresenta sila, nagbigay sila ulit ng another set of, what do you call this, relief goods, diba? Relief goods.
Relief goods, yes, relief goods.
So it's very it's a very we're very blessed so far na, na we have this kind of community government service helping us as well. Yung nga. And then
now, that's good governance. That's good governance.
Sa akin lang din kasi but of course kung isipin mo rin, dapat sa, if it will also depend on the number of family members. So, kung ang relief good team mo is good for tatlong tao, dapat nating damihan kasi marami yung ano. That's why the our barangay is also asking for survey. Ilan ba ang tao diyan sa bahay? Para sa ganun, matansya talaga nila yung ilan ba dapat na ibibigay natin. Para sa ganun, walang ano, walang sobra at saka walang kulang. Yun. And
all right, yes.
Good.
Ayun. So yes, sir. So that's yun yung sabi ko nga, pag sinabi pag ganyan yung istorya, of course, my output, good governance 'yan. Kasi in like places like Kaintahir in Rizal, and then of course, my hometown, my town Pasig, good governance is in effect. Makikita natin kung sino dito yung ano. In this crisis talaga, you will see, yes, Mayor Vico, of course, ang bay ng Twitter ngayon.
Good governance.
People of Twitter.
Kapansa kataning nga daw eh.
Good governance.
Yes, Red. Yes, Red. May angal.
Good
yes,
governance.
Red. Ano?
Pumunta kayo sa Quezon City, hanapin niyo yung good governance. Hindi
Hanap niyo po yung si Ligaya. Si Miss Ligaya? Asan po ba si Miss Ligaya?
Asan si Miss Ligaya?
Namun ba sa sayo doon yun eh?
Ang namin kagabi.
Wey, magaling-galang. Talamot kayo sa sayo doon eh.
Oh, you know, offense sa Tubong Quezon City ako. I am a bit worried also to my mga neighbors ko dyan sa Project 8. Sana okay din kayo.
Oy, Project 8, lapit lang dito. Hindi ko lang ako sumitali pa pa.
Ah, lapit ka talaga? That's good to know. Pero kung mahanap niyo rin si Ligaya, then that will be, ano, so that she can explain herself. That will be very...
Hindi ko si Ligaya sa amin dito sa Talipapa, dito sa barangay Agape. Sa ibo niya Agape, kasi kung ngayon siya nagpunta, na araw pa siya, edi hinabol ko siya at inapos yung interview ko siya.
Scoop yan.
Scoop eh. Yeah, so
may kanya-kanya tayo. Yes, Gary, go.
Yeah, but sa amin din kasi, to be honest, hindi wala rin kasi yung government na or barangay na perfecto. So meron ding minsan mga flaws na ayoko na rin i-mention kasi so far so good, they are really doing their best. Pero ang sakit kasi tingnan pa rin kung paglabas mo, ang dami pa rin tao. Parang
totoo.
Tapos I have to verify kung meron ba silang quarantine pass. Hindi, andun po sila, nandun sila sa labas, nagtatambay kasi mainit daw. Okay, baka hindi ba kayo natatakot? It's really scary.
Malapit na ito, may tutupada pa eh.
Hindi sila natatakot sa sarili nila or sa family nila. Matakot sila sa ibang, matakot din sila sa ibang tao na baka pwede sila maka-infect. Remember that the coronavirus can be asymptomatic. Everybody can get it.
Mm. And you don't and then you can get tested twice and then you can still contract it.
Yeah.
Mm-mm. Speaking of COVID-19, I actually watched the full episode ng documentary ni Howie Severino when he was admitted to Fidel Mundo Hospital.
Eyewitness?
Ayun yung Eyewitness, yes. Nasa YouTube siya actually. Now.
Okay.
Yeah. So pwede panoorin ng kahit na sino. And so on YouTube, after they aired the broadcast, siguro a few hours after that, na-release na yung full episode. And I'm happy kasi kailangan eh. Is that relevant to ano eh? How does being a patient of COVID-19 feel? Kumusta yung frontliners? And then of course, the discrimination nga na of course, pinaliwanag ni Presidente na do not discriminate.
Well, what would you?
You know, it's quite sad. It's quite sad kasi nga, not only kasi din sa Pilipinas, even in outside, even in the United States, meron din silang ganun na discrimination. Na,
yes. Nasatas ang discrimination doon.
Oh, yes. My mom is actually in Anaheim, California right now. And I'm really worried about her. Pero yung nga lang, naikwento din niya na, ano, na there's a lot of discrimination. Even not, hindi na talaga nationality yung ano eh. Hindi kung saan ka nanggaling, kung meron ka or wala. So, since the virus is not really visible to everyone, it's like, okay, so, and you're, but if you are tagged as a frontliner, talagang meron talagang discrimination because of one, maybe because of fear, of course, because pwede ka ma-infect. Pero with the kind understanding sana na they're doing their best to save lives, not to infect others, yun na lang sana ang tamang mindset na sana makuha nila instead of, you know, having discrimination.
No, well, as one song says, this is America. Well, that's America for all of us. Pero in Japan, alam nyo, here's the thing eh. I'm Red, let's clarify this out. Sa Japan, they don't have a lockdown. They only have a state of national emergency.
That's true. Ngayon, as far as I know, yun ang babasa ko sa Anime News Network and other websites. Abe, we call it Paring Abe. To expand the state of national emergency to all of Japan. Kasi una, it was only 7 prefectures, of course, including Tokyo.
Correct.
Pero yun na, right now, what happened in Japan was just, oh my God, yun naman ang sabi ko. Right now, they have 10,000 cases.
10,000 cases reported.
10,000 cases na sila sumipa. Take note, this is the same country that has dilly-dallied on the postponement of the Olympics.
Actually, yes. Oo, totoo. parang sinasabi, this is what I say with Japan, ngayon palang nagigising ang gobyerno ninyo sa katotohanan. Mas nauna pa ang Pilipinas sa inyo. Why? Late pa ang Pilipinas. Late pa ang Pilipinas. Technically. Yes, right.
Yeah, and take note. Yung mga nababasa ko ngayon, yung mga nakikita ko sa feed natin, mga people, I have friends who are in Japan right now. Nakikita ko, nababasa ko na parang they are hating the government right now because of its inaction. Inaction. Nagsimula lang yan sa Diamond Princess.
Yes.
Diamond Princess. Yan talaga ang pinaka, yung sinasabi nga natin, the moment na talagang that blindsided the Japanese government. And yun nga, they dallied on the Olympics. They're saying na kung hindi umurong ang Canada and Australia, baka hanggang ngayon tuloy pa rin ang Olympics.
Oh, that's scary.
Considering how many years has Japan prepared for this?
Yeah.
Oh, 2013 pa nga yata eh, no? 2013. Oh. Kasi nung pumunta pa ako ng Tokyo,
bedding pa lang yan.
Facilities eh.
Oo. Bedding pa lang yan.
Ganun katagal yun. Imagine, I was in Japan 5 years ago, ginagawa na yung stadium, yung mga ibang facilities na kailangan. Pero I'm sure hindi naman lahat eh. Pero at least, doon pa lang, nag-ano na eh,
naghahandaan na. Tapos may mga iba't ibang mga promotional materials.
Yes, yes. So yeah, Tokyo 2020. They already had their venue. They already had their, ano, no? Someone who is into branding, well, so-so ako dun sa logo ng Tokyo 2020. Pero we're going to talk about Tokyo 2021. All events 2021. Na, oh. And nabalitaan ko in Japan, before you make an amendment into anything, kailangan may perma mo muna yan, may stamp mo muna yan. Uso pa rin daw ang stamp sa Japan. So, well, ayun. So, I think that's Japan for now. And, as far as I'm seeing, yung mga foreigners, mga gaijin, who are staying in Japan, working in Japan, yun, sila yung mas conscious in these efforts until I saw Bandri TV Live 2020 na naka-Zoom meeting na sila, yung mga hosts. So, parang, well then, nagigising pa lang po ang Japan sa katotohanan na this is the new normal. And now, namimigay na sila ng Zoom backgrounds. So I have yung mga na binibigay nila sa Twitter from Review Starlight to Is the Order Rabbit to Final Fantasy namigay daw eh. Pero Studio Ghibli namigay for Zoom backgrounds for teleconferencing.
Actually, pwede rin sa StreamYard. Pwede rin dito sa StreamYard kaso baka di kayanin ng mga PC natin.
Hindi kakayanin ng browser yan kasi may limit ang browser. And StreamYard works in the browser, which is interesting. Your app, ano, walang apps, no apps. You can use it on the phone like what the Dennis is doing. So, interesting tong StreamYard. And looking forward, ito na yung magiging platform for the DTVPH live streams from here on, ano?
Yeah, right now...
So yun, okay. Hindi pa natin masyado nakakausap. Yes, ready.
Let's go. Right now, this is unusual. Mm-hmm. Yun lang ang sabi ko. This is very much unusual. Nakapalimado.
Hindi talaga ano eh. Kumbaga, it took me 30 days to realize, oh man, nagbago na ang mundo. This is no longer the normal. At I had to be convinced by my boss that this is not the normal that we are, kumbaga parang, this is unprecedented eh. When was the last epidemic na naganito ang scale? Perhaps the bubonic plague of the 1900s. Tama? That's 1900s, no?
1900s.
Spanish flu. So, Spanish flu. Tapos, meron pa tayong German measles. Tapos, ano pa ba? China, the Communist Party of China doesn't want to call this the Chinese flu, the Wuhan flu. And the epoch times of the Falun Gong following, established by the Falun Gong followers, are calling this a CCP virus. So, di ba? We live in interesting times, as one news agency na kilala ko or saying. So, ayun ano, hindi pa natin masyadong nakakausap si Boss Dennis. So, we're happy na walang masyadong cases dyan sa La Union. But at the same time, the tourism, events industries are crippled. Two legs, two arms, crippled yan. And by Tuesday, our company will be hosting a meeting like this about the events industry, what will happen from here. And I'm sharing that to all the event organizers, regardless kung anong niche tayo, because the events industry is crippled. It needs help. And it will have to adjust in the new normal. So, ayan ano. Sige, let's give the final words, final thoughts. Kyle, anong masasabi mo so far? Final thoughts.
So far, ano naman eh. Ano mo masabi ngayon eh. May ginagawa ko, sorry.
Sige, sorry. Sige, si Dennis, ano masasabi mo ngayon? Final words.
Final words, sundin natin yung kumpleto. That's all we can do right now. It's for our safety naman eh.
Totoo. Gary, sa ano, lipat tayo sa iyo sa Cebu. What can you say? Final words. Cut ka, nakat ka. Cut, Gary, cut. Wala kang audio.
Sorry, nakamit ako. Okay. But if you think about the totality of what's happening right now, okay, so there was bubonic plague, there was Spanish flu. I know we were not born nung time na yon, but I heard, but based on the facts and data, millions died because of that. Here in this era, it's digital, we have a lot of technologies that's happening. We're fighting on something that's very unknown. And yet, there are certain clues that's helping us, helping us recover, helping us avoid getting infected. So I can say that we're still lucky. We are still lucky that hindi siya parang type of virus na parang pag pumasok sa'yo, mamatay ka in minutes or in a few seconds. So we're still lucky. I will accept the fact that yes, this could be the new normal for this year. But I'm still optimistic that there will be a vaccine that will be happening anytime soon this year, and hopefully there will be a cure. And sana hindi na mag-escalate to a different severity of infection or mutation. And ingat lang, just like everybody is tell, just like I said before, follow the rules and let's all be careful of spreading. Let's all be careful on spreading the right information. Ingat.
All right, sige. Thank you very much, Gary Montejo from Cebu City, one of our partners sa Keepsakes, and also the Cebu's Cosplay Event Buzzer. Balik tayo kay Kyle. Kyle,
yun ang masabi ko lang naman, kasi this is panahon na to na we live in some uncertainty, no? So siguro talaga, kay, as much as yun nga, it's a cliche, some may don't like to follow the government, pero yun talang magagawa natin ngayon eh. Kasi isipin na lang natin lahat tayo may COVID. Yan lang ang i-instance mga mindsets natin. Kahit sabihin natin na we're physically fit, just think of it that anytime you may be carrying a ticking time bomb. Yun na lang ang ang instance sa mga isip natin.
Correct.
All right. So nga, on to your head. Yes, yes, Kyle.
Ayun, the cure may take time bago may develop. So siguro before the cure gets developed, tayo na mismo maging cure to fight this pandemic. Tayo na mismo ang lunas muna.
That's true.
Hanggang makapagbuwang siyensya, tayo sa community must be the first line. Yun lang ang siguro masasabi ko ngayon.
Thank you very much, Kyle. Follow him sa Twitter, Kyflow. Ayan, Red, on to you. Final words.
Okay, this will be a bit shorter. Not necessarily shorter, pero yun lang sasabi ko. Okay, first. Right now, this is a very different world. This is a world where we never expected it to happen. We never expected it na mangyayari. A few weeks ago, we were happy na siguro makapag-mall, makapag-nanood ng senior, anything. Mm-hmm. We were just a few months ago, or even we were able to party, like in February, going to July 2020, and thinking that this decade would be the best, would be the good, would be what 2019 was not. Apparently, it's not. 2020 is a big decade starter for us. It punches right into the gut. The only thing I could say is, of course, working right now at a newspaper of national newspaper is that reporting this disease from your desk is a bit, sabihin natin, a bit off, a bit iffy, kasi you wanted to be on the front lines right now, but
every time I write an article or check the articles that that our reporters send for our for me to check upon and edit it, and I always look at the sense now. We're not just here sitting at our desks. Forget na kaupo lang kami sa desk or we're working from home right now and hindi na kami online sa ano na to. No. Media right now, the media industry is also a frontliner in this situation. Hindi lang po yung mga TV people, and of course, I want to stress this out. Hindi lang po TV people, hindi lang po radio people ang frontliners, but also the people as well. We print have a record. We touch our news sources. Nahahawakan namin yung balita because we print the news in a printed manner. Right now, of course, people are saying print is dying. Mamatay na yung print. And of course, right now, we are, of course, every newspaper right now is having the same problem of advertising crunch. Kasi nga, wala eh. Hindi makapag-labas sa mga ads or even makapag-release sa magbayad ng mga advertisers. But right now, print right now is invaluable right now. As much as people would say television is the new medium, TV, radio, no. Print is the new, is still there for us, still there for you to give you the news and give you more insightful analysis than ever before. Of course, right now the issue is, media, of course, there's a problem with media right now. But as a media worker myself, I want you to think about, I want you to say na, please trust us. Please trust us. Please trust our people from TV, from radio, from print, from online. Please trust us. We report the news, give the facts, and we inform opinions, and of course, to dismiss this information. We always try very hard to dismiss this information. We ask the hard questions to everyone or to everyone. And we try our best to be fair. Of course, you would say na ang dyaryo may kanya-kanyang killing yan. We understand. Of course, the way the newspaper started, it was just yun nga, the opinion section. Pero please continue to trust print. As a media worker myself, working in the print media, please trust print. Please. And of course, trust online, our online editions as well. We also break news on our online editions, but of course, please trust print because we deliver the news. We deliver the news more insightful in print. So this is a very, very soft segue to say na please buy the Manila Times.
Next. Dumaan. Pero I have a question. How many years do you guys think this will last? How many months or years?
Again.
The virus, this epidemic, what's happening right now?
No. We would say na this virus right now, hindi siya magtatagal, 2 years lang siguro. 2 years, we would
say 2 years. 2 years, malala na siguro. May na yung malalang period.
Mm-mm. This year is already yung pinaka-peak ngayon. I reported in the Times that Johnson & Johnson has already has already had a candidate vaccine. Candidate pa lang, ha? Not a vaccine itself. Candidate vaccine that they are researching. Mm-hmm. They are preparing for the tests on fourth quarter of this year, and they aim for mass production on 2021. But of course, it's only a candidate vaccine. Candidato. So, anything goes. But right now, impossible at this moment. We could hold big events. Not at this time. Yeah. Right now. At nawala pala
si Ayan. So I was supposed to say ano, guys, this is
nawala.
Naubusan ako ng load.
Naubusan ka ng load.
Ayun, Lupet. Nice. Ayan. So, ladies and gentlemen, this is an experiment in progress. I-share ko sa inyo. Yes. This is an experiment. Oh, wala na akong load. Nag-time out din tayo, mga Chong.
Nahinig ka pa namin. Sorry.
Really nice. Really nice. Ayan. So, wait lang. I'll just wait for the signal to go well for me. Okay. Ayan, game na. Ayan yung window ko ngayon ng ping.
Okay na ba? Okay.
Time out. Mga walang load.
Oh dear.
Ayan. So, when StreamYard said that this system is preferred to be on a wired connection, they mean it.
Oo.
So, you know, so okay, again, we had a great discussion. Oh, wow. So now for my parting words before we wrap this podcast, and I just need to check if nagta-time out ako eh. Okay, naman mag-time out, Chong. Ayan, nagta-time out ako. Ayan.
We can still hear you clearly. Am
I up? Am I up?
Yes, hindi ka choppy.
Okay, good. So again, hey, thank you very much. So again, the events industry is shaking. The cosplay community is having its online sessions basically every day. Cosplay events organizers are leveraging the internet to serve as a platform for the, of course, first 2 weeks we had the online cosplay convention. There's QuaranCon, there's Ozin lumapit na rin sa akin to give away tickets should the quarantine period ends and the next Ozin Fest event be held, and may napili na tayo. For the meantime, cosplay.ph has presented its platform, cosplaymania.com, to the cosplay community na to a contest. Mamimigay rin sila ng tickets to the next Cosplay Mania event. Again, it's a series. And the World Cosplay Summit has announced its Twitter contest, social media contest called Taku Cos. Cosplay from home. Cosplay from home. So, yun yung mga developments natin, no? Again, if you're wondering, asa na po yung cosplayers that globally WCS? So, tapos na po yung operations nila. And it's just there as an archive. So, with that said, you can follow us. Me, of course, nandiyan na po sa ibaba yung links natin. I have a podcast twice a month. Every 2 weeks on anchor.fm/keepsakes. And our next episode will be about the online cosplay convention nga. So that's Mondays at 9 a.m. DTV Pilipinas is at dtvpilipinas.org and on Facebook. Again, Kaipo is on Twitter. Sino na ano ngayon? Sino Oshi mo?
So, wala muna.
Wala muna Oshi.
Papakaw tayo ngayon.
Walang idol-idol. Yung mga idol natin online, parati nagko-Kumu. Speaking of Kumu, ha, nagdagdagan yung fans ni Kumu.
Yeah.
Even the yes, Red.
Actually, Cebu had a 5 million peso, $5 million investment investment from sabi nga nung sa billionaire yata, tatlong pamilya. It's actually from Globe. Actually, not Globe directly, but from Kickstart Ventures.
Yes.
From Globe. Summit Media, which is owned by Gokongway, specifically not Gokongway itself, but Visa Gokongway. Separate yan, ha? Separate yung Summit Media sa DG Summit. And of course, ABS-CBN, whom we all know is owned by the Lopezes. Pero parang fate accompany nila sa ABS-CBN because they have been having shows there on Kumu. Nakakapagtaka nga na may shows sila before the investment.
By the way, speaking of ABS-CBN, tuloy ba ang ano? Ano ba yung status ng ABS-CBN ngayon?
Wala.
Yeah, that's what I'm
broadcasting. Wala. Suspended lahat ng mga hearing siguro sa franchise. We're not talking about franchise now eh.
Our court reporter said that our court reporter, of course, we have our, sa Manila tayo, we have our own, the best in the business court reporter. And right now, yung April 14 na, actually, yung April 14 dapat na session, wala.
It didn't happen.
Because the Baguio summer session has been canceled. Justice has had a session last Friday via Zoom, huh?
Oh, dear, Zoom.
Oh, pero they did not discuss about the investment petition, but they discussed about the prisoner, yung register of the prisoners, release of the elderly prisoners, and yung sa health concerns ng presidente. Pero yun nga, walang action dun sa health, dun sa demand ng health details ng presidente. But all the prisoners, DOJ has been ordered to answer within 10 days of the order na sumagot sila dun sa petition dun sa release ng mga elderly prisoners. So yun. So yung ABS-CBN case, God knows when. Yan lang masasabi ko.
God knows when. So, kumbaga, and take note. Hiwalay natin yung usapan.
Oo. And take note, the clock is ticking. Ang date na kinikita ngayon, May 4.
May 4. Alright. Right. So again, it has been April 18, 2020. God knows when, kung kailan matatapos itong mga bagay-bagay na ito. Ano? Again, all that we can do is we have to stay home, keep safe, and pray that this epidemic will leave. Ayan na po. So, President Duterte, anong story sa
Manila? Ano yan? Kanina pa yan. I'm just promoting the Manila Times stop, Manila Times Online.
Okay.
Ayan. Visit the Manila Times Online, Manila Times stop yan. Sasya na baliktad yung camera. But yes, it's Manila Times stop.
Baliktad talaga yung camera. The Manila Times.net.
So we are online optimized, mobile optimized.
Okay. Yes. Yes. Si Paul Medina ba yun? Si Pugad Baboy ba yung nakita ko?
Hindi. Si ano yun? Di ba yun?
Pugad Baboy is na online daw.
Hindi, matagal na ba online si Pugad Baboy since Rappler pa eh. Pero bumalik siya sa Jared eh, ba si Pugad Baboy? Bumalik sa Jared si Pugad Baboy. Inquire na yata?
Star.
Nice. So, from all of us here at DTV Pilipinas in Keepsakes, and with that said, stay home, keep safe, and wash your hands.
Keep safe.
This is a broadcast.
Please,
not more. Hindi alcohol. Ang sabon at ang pagugas ng kamay should be a habit. And nakalsalalay ang buhay natin sa literally sa ating mga kamay.
Ang alcohol hindi iniinom, pinapahid.
Pinapahid. At dahil
ngayon may liquor ban.
May liquor ban at huwag niyo pong iinumin yung paintiner parang awa niyo na.
Di at least naintindihan na namin na kailangan talaga bawal ang uminom. Kasi nangyari nagtagayan sila ayun dahil sa baso nagka-infected ang mga tao. 77. Yun nga.
Well, sa inyo?
Yun daw ang ano eh, yun daw yung sabi-sabi dahil daw sa tagay. Oh, dahil daw sa baso na tagayin sila, hindi nila alam yung isa yung infected. Eh, infected lahat sila. Awa naman.
Ayan, sige. Let's end this broadcast.
Huwag na kayo
magkakaw. Sige, go.
Magiging tinola yung mga manok ninyo.
Yes, please.
Huwag niyo maging tinola. Sayak, malang tinola yun.
Tinalong manok.
Tinalo na nga, naging tinola. Tinalo, naging tinola, di ba?
Tinalong manok.
Tinalong manok.
Di pa nga, nakakasabong talo na agad.
Right. Awit.
Awit.